Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 2, 3, and 4 of I Will Become a Villainess That Will Go Down in History. I know, it's been a hot minute. It's been 3 weeks between this and Argo Ship, and how we could put freaking Blue Exorcist in there. There's like two other shows, Blue Exorcist and one other show that I'm like 3 weeks behind due to everything of all this transpired, but I'm trying to catch up. I only have today and Sunday because, and maybe a little bit of tomorrow, but really not Friday because I'm not coming home until late. But other than that, let's go ahead and get started with episode 2 in 3, 2, 1. Excuse me. Oh, and are you gonna try to sneak out, honey? They're gonna find you. Body. Are you sure? Excuse me. Excuse me. Really? It's stuck in my throat. Oh my God. Cool. Regardless. Well, I like the fact that she made a friend. All through the night? Oh, I know she's over. Okay. Yeah, she's. Oh, Oh, definitely. Yeah, gotta know everything, you know? Really? So? What the hell does that matter? If she's a girl and if she's 10, regardless, let her try. You didn't have to lash out on her. I get it for the time and such, and saying that, oh yeah, girls should be dainty. Girls should be this. Girls should be that. Women shouldn't be doing this. Women shouldn't be. It's the freaking 21st century! You know, now we really don't give a ish about that anymore. Girl, women can do anything just as much as a man can. Please, I mean, just because she's 10, she isn't a kid anymore. Oof. I don't think that's good, though. Thank you. Yes. Thank goodness. Everyone Alicia talks to, because when she is explaining about villainous, they're looking at her like, "Art girl, what the hell?" Oh, okay, so she's gotta be 13 now.
That's right, so you can't really say or do anything about it.
He's just giving her medicine. That's all I see right now. We're not counting that, so it's just medicine. That's all it is. Okay. Once again, they are cute together, even though once again, that age link, cause she like what? It's been 2 years, I'm guessing also now, because the last age that we saw was 10, so she's got to at least be like 15, no, not 15, 12 or 13 and such. But look at that height. Now, let's talk about the little town that she went to that, of course, is in poverty and such, and it's not the greatest. You do feel bad for those people. I'm glad that she met Will, because Will is going to be like her second father figure, so I hopefully in episodes 3 and 4 going into 5 next week that we do kind of see a little bit more of her going over there and talking to Will, because I love the fact that, number one, he used to work at the kingdom up until his situation. So she's learning more about the kingdom before when she was born. And that's a good thing. She needs to know a lot of things. Love the fact that the king was also mentioned in this. But I'm grateful of the fact is that she was able to save the boy, because that poor baby, I cannot imagine living in a country or a place and not knowing when your next meal is gonna be. I hate watching videos. Okay. There are two types of videos in the world that I cannot stand watching. I'll even say three. So one of them is, the dog commercial that comes up, the in the eyes of in the arms of the angel, I believe. I hate watching that commercial, so anytime when I see it, I end up changing the channel for like a couple of minutes because it's super sad and depressing and such. And I hate seeing dogs or any type of animal that way. Then the second one is any country where it's kids or even just people around my age and they have no home or no food or anywhere to go and such. And then also my third and final one is the recent stuff that are happening still in G Word. And you still see it all over on TikTok. And I always send my love, my hope, and prayers for them that, people are able to get out of that situation and to make a difference, a better situation for themselves and escape and have a brand new life. And I feel so bad for people. And still to this day of what is going on, I just hope and pray that it's over soon with everything. I feel like we're in a future, and I hope and pray that there is a day that we don't have to worry about any of these situations anymore and such. And it makes me cry, and I'm trying not to cry now. I've already cried too much these last couple of weeks. Right now I'm at a highly emotional state. I just hope that everything will be okay for a lot of people and pets in general. But no, this was a good episode. I really enjoyed it a lot. But yeah, that ending though, we'll talk about that in the next episode. I still, like, it's an indirect kiss. He's only helping her to get better. That's all. So yes, we'll go ahead and pause the video and I will see you in 1 second for episode 3. Ready? Episode 3 in 3, 2, 1, go. Yeah, how are you feeling? Good, good. Well, let's hope you don't get in trouble, honey. You're the heroine. She's pretty! Okay, her voice also sounds familiar. Let's go ahead and find out who she's voiced by. Yeah, but she's friendly, though. Where'd she go? True. And she's still writing. Oh my God. Well, hey, she's a smart ass 10-year-old. Just divergent. Met her today. But you know, we can't talk about that just yet. Thank you. Look how lovable she looks. Right. Alicia, you're just playing in the palm of her hand. Her aura, I can't. Ooh. I still haven't had a macaron and I want one so bad. Well, baby, she just wants to know more about you. Off. Likewise. Good. And so she's now 13. Her watcher. Okay, hold up. Her being her watcher, is that gonna be like the same thing how Liz Taylor was in the one other show? Possibly, or is she just gonna be watching her like, oh hey, just in case she messes up on something that at least she is there to help her, possibly? But she looks so pretty. Look at her. Oh my god. Baby has grown. Oh my goodness. But no, I'm so happy for her. She got into the school on her own. No help with anyone. Even though, yes, she still is a royal and such. But still, she did it on her own accord. Very, very happy. Claps for her. Now, but she's made further bonds, not only with Will and Gil. Like, that was very interesting, and I wonder how that's going to continue on going into the next episode and the next up and coming weeks with this show. But it could be good. This could be a really good thing for her because I feel like at the same time, she is going to help that town. She's probably going to talk about it in the second half of the show and be like, hey, we need to do something for these people. Everyone is in poverty. Their little small village is not the greatest, and we need to help them. I think she's probably gonna do that. I would love to see her do that because she seems like a person who really cares for people, even though, you know, her villainous facade. This is like a very interesting episode. I love the fact that we got to see Liz a little bit more in this episode, but yeah. The fact that, number one, she's voiced by Akane, best girl Akane from Oshi, like, that's a win. That surely is, because I would have, my thing was, I was thinking it was somebody else, and then I was like, well, let me look. Let me check real quick. And the fact is, it's baby girl. It's the best girl besides Kana. But Akane. Akane is number one, because look at her! Freaking look at her! She's gorgeous, and I love her so much. She's baby. But other than that, guys, go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 5. I don't know. No, wait. 4. My dumb behind. Where are we going? I'll see you in a minute for episode 4. Alrighty. Episode 4 in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, let me check. She did. You do. Right. She has no choice, though. That's right. We have to. I know. Question is, are you gonna get her a prostate leg? Did I say that right? Prostate? Get her a leg? Prosthetic. There we go. Prosthetic leg! summoning her out of the blue? Help me. Help me! Help me! Oh my She's right. course, you know, he enjoyed it. Duke definitely enjoyed that ish. I mean, would I say that was a battle, though? I wouldn't think it's a battle. I think it was, like, just an argument? Or just a little spat? But she is handling it well, let's just say that. Now, the fact that her and Gil are there together, and she was able to save Rebecca. Once again, I hope she's able to give her a prosthetic leg so that she can walk around, but something tells me, like, we just gotta wait and see. But Rebecca definitely will tell the word of Alicia to so many people that every single time she comes in, there's gonna be, like, a parade or some ish every single time she comes in. But she's definitely making that small village possibly a happier one. So hopefully by the end of this show, that village is in a better environment than it currently is as of right now. But no, this was a really... all three of these episodes were very interesting in their own way. I love the fact that, number one, we got to see her grow up quickly and such, because I was wondering how long it was going to be until she was her actual age as a villainess and she was going to meet Liz. Love the fact that we met Liz in the previous episode. The banter that these two have every single week as of now is cute. Because of the fact is, like, you have someone as Alicia who's trying to do all these things to make her mad. But with Liz, Liz just like, I'll take it with a smile. And that's the biggest thing. Pissing people off with a smile. Yes, indeed. Very good, very good. You even have to do that with people that you don't like. Even no matter how badly they piss you off, giving someone a smile, and especially with how pissed they are, can always just be the worst thing about their day and such. Knowing that you are not over here yelling back at them, cussing them out and such. Just giving them that one little smile and be like, yes, I'm going to have a better day with you, instantly will ruin their day. So if anybody ever pisses you off and stuff, you know, don't stoop down to their level. You know, Be the bigger person, do a little bit of kindness, and show them that irresistible smile of yours, and then let them, you know, walk off all pissed and stuff, mad and bitter, because, you know, people are like that. You're going to meet so many people like that in the world regardless. But no, all three of these episodes were really good, highly ready for the next episode, even though I gotta wait until Tuesday, but really, probably, depending on how it is, because I'm not coming home until late at night next Tuesday, so I know I will be definitely tired, but I will try to get episode 5 out for you, if not on Tuesday, probably Wednesday morning while I'm asleep. So I'll record it Tuesday night and shit like that. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction review towards episodes 2, 3, and 4 of I'll Become a Villainess That'll Go Down in History. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all either Tuesday night when I come home from work or Wednesday morning pre-recorded for episode 5. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.